picking it up. Yeah. I'm loving, I'm living, I'm picking it up. Yeah. I'm picking it up. Yeah. Picking it up. I'm loving, I'm living, so we turning, we turning it up.
What's up, Glam Fam? I missed you guys so much. Welcome, welcome back. And if you're new, welcome to our channel. You can go ahead and subscribe. We would love to have you be a part of the Glam Fam. So I know it's been about 4 weeks, a whole month, you guys. And my baby did break my camera. So that's why I've been gone for so long, you guys. Let me show you guys what she actually did. So this was my baby here, and look what she did to the screen. She ripped it completely apart from my camera. So with that and being busy, I didn't know whether I wanted to get my camera fixed or get an upgrade. So with her breaking my camera, it kind of gave me the excuse to upgrade my camera. So I did get a new camera, which I'm filming on now, and I absolutely love it. I love the quality of it. Let me know in the comments below if you guys are loving the quality of this camera. Okay, so this video, I wanted to do kind of like an update and just catch you guys up on what's going on in my life and some new things that are gonna be happening. So I just want to catch you guys up on everything. I did write some stuff down on my phone. So if you see me looking at my phone, that's what I'm looking at. So first I wanna talk about the house. So I know it's been a while since I've kind of updated you guys on the house. We are super excited because since we bought the house, the value on it has went up so much, you guys. Like, it's crazy how much this house is worth now. So I'm like, that's so awesome that we made the decision to move when we did, because we've made so much equity. It's insane. You know, I know it's like skyrocketing through the roof right now with everyone trying to buy right now because of quarantine and all that stuff. We made like the best decision at the time that we did, so I'm super excited about that. And I am gonna come back with a furnished tour very, very, very soon. It's been about 10 months we've been in this house. I cannot believe how fast that has went, 10 whole months. So I know it takes people about almost a year to fully get their house kind of the way they want it. And we pretty much feel like we've gotten there. I just want to add a few more things, and I'm gonna definitely bring you guys a furnished tour, so don't trip. It's coming, it's coming. And I know a couple of people, like our friends, some of our family have seen the house in person, but there's still a lot of family who have not seen our house. So that's why we are gonna do a furnished tour. And also, we're also gonna do a video as well on how to buy a house. Just trying to get my husband to sit down and make a video is like insane. So, but he definitely mentioned it, and we're definitely gonna get that done this weekend. So we'll do that and get those videos out. So we're gonna have some more house videos coming up, so don't even trip. Okay, so next I wanted to talk about quarantine and the schooling and the kids and all that stuff. Quarantine is still going pretty okay for me. I'm like a homebody anyways, and you know, things are starting to open up now, so I'm excited about that. You know, I was able to take the kids to, like, you know, Scandia and stuff during the summer break, and I heard things are gonna start opening back up, so I'm super excited about that, and I'm just ready to get back out there and do my thing. So I'm just hoping that things open up. My oldest daughter, she's doing amazing. She's getting almost straight A's, so she's doing well despite the odds of the quarantine. She's doing really good, and my son is doing really good as well. He is getting, you know, good praises from his teacher and stuff. So you know, it's much harder for like he just turned 7, so 7-year-old. So but overall they're both doing great, so I'm excited that, you know, they're able to stay level-headed through this whole situation, and we're getting emails and stuff from the school. So they might be opening back up soon. I have not decided yet if I'm gonna put them back in school. I keep going back and forth. My daughter really wants to go back, so I'm hoping they start with like 1 or 2 days a week. That I can do. I can start off like that, and for the most part, just keep them in hybrid. So we'll just see how that goes, but overall, we're doing okay. You know, our mental is good, and I just keep praying to God that things just keep getting better, and it's looking good. I have high hopes for 2021, so we'll see. Okay, so we're gonna talk about my hair business. So hair business is good. You know, one of my concerns with moving up here, as you guys know, was, you know, is my client still gonna come and all that, and they still have been faithful to me. I've even got a bunch of new clients, so that's exciting. I also released my mink line, which is going great. I'm getting a lot of support from, you know, people with that, and a lot of orders coming in, so I'm super excited about that. And I know I have to bring more client videos, you guys. It's just been, you know, with my camera being broke and everything, I have to get back on track now. So yeah, everything with my hair business is going great. So last but not least, we're gonna discuss my breastfeeding journey. So you guys, it's coming up on 2 years. I cannot believe how fast that has went. Her second birthday is coming up in May, and I can't even believe how far we've came in this journey. I remember starting, and I was like so nervous. I'm like, you know, am I gonna be able to do it? You know, then I went 6 months, and then a year, and then here we are coming up on 2 years. It's like so, such a blessing. Okay, so why I want to stop. So it's not more so that I want to stop. I feel like I kind of need to stop in a sense. I feel like if it's up to her, she would go literally until she's 18 years old. Like, she is so attached, and she just loves it so much, and, you know, of course she does. that's her joint right there. But I feel like for me, at times it can get kind of overwhelming because she is still breastfeeding through the night. She's still breastfeeding all day. If I'm around, it's like she won't even chill with me. She's like pulling at my clothes no matter where we are. Like, it's just kind of getting, you know, overwhelming. And I feel like, you know, 2 years is more than enough. They recommend a year. And I feel like we went above and beyond with our 2 year journey. And I've went this long because, you know, this is my last baby, and I wanted to share every experience I can with her. And I literally think it was the best decision ever. But I am now starting my journey with weaning. I actually started April 1st, but it didn't go too good the first 2 days. I gave in both days, but yesterday actually I bought her a cup, and it was like a cup/bottle type of thing, because she's never had a bottle before. Like, we're talking about a baby who's never had a bottle ever. So I put some milk in it, some regular whole milk, and she actually was like, you know, drinking it. And, you know, so I was like, okay, you know, but she's still, of course, asking for breast milk. So we're just gonna keep slowly working at it. I know some people go cold turkey, but that's not something I'm trying to do. I don't really have a rush. So I've had a trip planned for me and my husband for a couple of months now. I already booked it and paid for it, and it's in June. So I do have to kind of be done, because we will be away, and obviously I can't breastfeed her because she's not coming with us. So I know by June she has to be fully weaned. So while there's no rush, you know, we do have to get moving, because June will be here before we know it. And yeah, guys, like, this is crazy. I know it's gonna be a rough journey. Some kids wean off right away. I know she's gonna be one of the ones where she's gonna be fighting me, okay, to the death. And it's a very emotional thing for me. Like, I can't even really talk about it without wanting to cry, or actually cry. Because, you know, that's something special that me and her have, and it kind of feels like I'm taking something away from her, even though you shouldn't feel like that. I feel like I'm literally taking me away from her in a sense. I know she knows I'll still love her and cuddle with her and all that stuff, but I'm just, it's just so emotional for me. Like, I can't, I can't even. So that's why I'm gonna do it the slow way and just cut feedings. So I'm gonna definitely keep you guys updated on that journey, of course. And if you have any tips, leave me some tips below, you guys. Like, anything helps. I've been watching YouTube videos, but it seems like nothing is really like sitting right with me. So just leave me some tips below if you have done it before and been successful. All right, guys, I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for watching my channel per usual. And your girl's back, so I know I went MIA, but don't even trip, I'm back, okay? And if you are new and you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button to join the Glam Squad, Glam Squad. All right, you guys, I'll see you in the next one. Bye.